He is one of the all-time great Chicago Bears. 13 seasons, 8 Pro Bowls, 4-time first-team All-Pro. One of the most fearsome middle linebackers of all time. Brian Urlacher has never appeared on this show before. This is his WGN Morning News debut. But he is here not to talk about just football or anything silly like that or the gigantic fish he's catching in retirement. He is here because there is something he wants to show all of you this morning.
Ta-da.
He's got hair!
I got hair.
Look at you!
Yep, look at it.
Let me take you all in with my own two eyes.
Yep.
First off, how in the hell did you keep that a secret for as long as you have?
Man, I wore a hat everywhere I went for a year.
Who knew about how? I mean, I'm stunned, number one, that you would give this exclusive to a rinky-dink show like this.
Why would you have me on before if I want to know?
That was a horrible decision on your part. But how many people knew about this beforehand?
You know, most of my family obviously knew, my kids, close friends.
Yeah.
Not many people at all, because I always wear a hat anyway.
Right.
But now I had to wear it when I went to dinner. I had to wear it when I dressed up. Well, for me dressing up, like right now, I'd have a hat on normally because of my hair. I couldn't show my hair.
So, and when did this whole process start? When have you had this full, thick, lustrous head of hair?
Oh, I've only had this thick hair for about 4 months.
It's still a long time.
It's a long time, but I had the procedure done over last November, so a year now.
Okay.
I
got to tell you, all those years of trying to get you on to talk football, had I have known it would have taken this to get you on, I would have sprung for the procedure myself.
It's a great procedure. Look, I think my hair is.
Now, I hear that I've heard nightmares about getting this thing done. They got to cut your...
It's not true.
No?
My procedure was unbelievable. There's no cuts on your head. There's no scars on the back of my head. This procedure, they take out one hair at a time, and they remove it from the back and put it in the front. Wherever you need to put the hair. For me, it was obviously right here.
I got to be honest. What made you decide to do it? Because I'm going to tell you, you were a fantastic-looking bald man.
I was happy to be bald.
Yeah.
I feel like I have a good-shaped bald head,
yes.
Which was a good thing. And I'd been bald my whole life.
You know,
I'd shave my head short. And then a buddy of mine went and got the procedure done. And he's pretty bald, too. And he goes, hey, bro, you know, you might want to check this out. And the good thing about it was if I got it done and didn't like it, guess what? I could still shave my head.
You could still shave
it. Because there's no scar anywhere on my head. I could still shave my head if I didn't like it, but I liked it.
Yeah.
So I went forward.
I don't even know if I want to talk about football. I really just want to keep talking about that hair.
Let's talk about my hair then.
You're on Twitter and all that, right?
I am on Twitter.
Now you understand.
I'm really good at Twitter. Yeah.
There's going to be a lot of
backlash. People aren't going to like the hair.
People don't like everything these days.
I'll say this. So when I first got it, I wasn't sure about it.
Yeah.
Because I hadn't seen myself with hair since probably high school, maybe college.
Yeah.
So it's a little different. Now when I see the picture of me bald, I'm like, whoa, way different. And I know it looks a little better because I was driving through a fast food restaurant one day and I had my hat off by accident. I was getting food and this girl goes, you look like Brian Urlacher, but he's a lot younger looking than you. I mean, a lot older looking than you. I go, this is when I had hair. She goes, he looks a lot older than you. I was like, you're right, thank you. So, you know, she basically told me I look kind of young, so that was good.
Probably running your fingers through it all the time.
I'm always twisting. You're right. I got so many things I can do now with my hair.
Yeah.
My showers take longer.
Yeah.
I got to leave a couple minutes to comb it in the morning, put gel in it sometimes now. It's great. Oh, look at the old picture. That's a good picture because I'm tan right there.
Yeah. God, you look so ferocious on the left. You almost look gentle.
You know how I know that
you're
it's
almost not frightening.
That it actually looks okay is my kids are like, Dad, your hair doesn't look bad. Because usually it doesn't look bad.
I gotta tell you, it looks natural. It's just shocking.
It doesn't look like it's not. It looks like my hair.
Yeah.
I believe it does at least. Yeah.
No.
You're stunned.
I'm speechless. I'm just trying to take you all in.
We got people laughing over here.
They love it. Look at them. They're enthralled over there.
Yes.
I appreciate that. Thank you. I feel good about it.
It's awesome, but I'm just shocked, you know?
So
it looks as good as Larry's.
How much hair I had when it started growing.
Yeah.
It was pretty shocking to me as well. I didn't think it was going to work, honestly, but it works for sure.
So a lot of that is your hair that grew in?
This is all my hair. So they took all the...
Where'd they take it from?
The back of my head where my hair is really thick. And
good.
They put it where my hair is not thick in the front or where it wasn't thick in the front, where it's actually not growing at all. And they put, you know, just replanted the hairs up there up front. And that was it.
So
one day procedure. Was in and out in the same day.
Has this made you a happier, more lighthearted person?
Look at him. Isn't he so relaxed now? I don't even know what this guy is. He's like a different human being.
I've always been relaxed. I just, during season, man, you know, when you're not winning and things aren't going well, it's not easy to be nice all the time.
That's true.
Would you be able to be a linebacker with that hair?
For sure. Guaranteed. Yeah, I could still do it. You know, I wouldn't get as many jokes about being bald from the guys in the locker room, you know?
Yeah.
But,
yeah.
Gotta be confident about
your hair. I think he got the wrong impression. When he played, he loved having 15 middle-aged men with Stone Age microphones in his face every day. He looked forward to that the most. Brian, thank you for coming on. And,
thank you.
For giving hope
to, bald
to
guys.
The bald men everywhere out there. You're a true hero. Forget about all that football nonsense. Look at this guy. He's got hair, everybody.
Lots of it.
For more information on Brian's new look, go to restorehair.com.
He looks cuddly.
It's almost
go cuddly. Give him a hug.
Good word.
Can you
better yet, Brian, why don't you tackle Robin as she runs across the see if you still got it.
I'm good. I'm done tackling people.
It looks good, Brian. Oh, thanks for being here.
Thank
what do you.
You
say, Paul?
Yeah. I'm second thinking.
Paul, come on.
My issue is with my hairstyle now, too. I have to figure out how I want to comb it and shape it. I still haven't got it real.
Try parting it right out the middle.
Figured out yet.
Have you seen this? Look at this.
Oh, Mr. McGill. It's all wrong.
He's got a good shaped head, though.
A beautiful shaped head.
He's got a nice shaped head.
One of the nicer ones around here. All right, hey, real quick, here's what.